This is going to be an amazing, profound moment for you when you get to see these panel present and hear their stories, because they were just where you were not that long ago. So ladies and gentlemen, Regina Garapi!
Collective. Married to Robert Reed, musician and fellow seeker, And she has one son.
Patrick.
A firm believer in magic. She has over 30 years of theater experience. She's a performing poet and improv artist. And she's incredibly happy to be in Chicago with the Ippies. Yeah. And a trailblazer 2 months later. She holds 2 master's degrees in psychology and social work. Lisa has practiced privately for over 20 years and additionally works as a school counselor. Lisa is passionate about helping others use visualization to realize their dreams through workshops and individual work. She is determined to change this world for the better, one visualization at a time.
Days off from work,
and they're here with me, and I obviously do not know how to teach this. And my honest to goodness feeling was, I should just cut my losses and let everybody go home. Let's just call it quits. Then I heard a voice. I hear voices. And it said, wait, hold on, look at the clock. You only have an hour to go. Do you think you can make it an hour? Took a deep breath and I thought, okay, I can do this for another hour. So I did. It was much of the same. Jen would hijack my magic corduroy. I would redirect. She would hijack. I would redirect. People later told me that were in attendance, it was really uncomfortable for them. I got it. It was very uncomfortable for me. But guess what? I did it. I made it to lunch. I ate lunch, and at that point I thought, I'll go figure out what I'm going to do next. And Jen made an announcement during lunch. She said she'd be leaving early.
Present. terrified of public speaking. Public speaking is one of the biggest phobias out there, right up there with fear of death. So here's my story relating to this. Many, many years ago, I went to Kampala to do a holistic health teacher training. And my dream was to come home and teach workshops to help other people and to be the one up leading the group rather than the attendee that I always was. But as I got home and the high of being around a group of like-minded people started to wear off, I quickly realized how frightened I was about getting up in front of a group. So that's kind of a problem when you want to teach a workshop. That's what it's all about. So, I just couldn't wrap my mind around how that was going to work out. So pretty quickly, I just had to let that dream go by the wayside. So how am I up here now speaking to all of you? Well, I'll tell you. Because our beloved Andy Dooley forced me. Against any better judgment I've ever had in my life, to go to Toastmasters. I'll never forget, it was our first coaching call together, and Andy was calling me from the second Orlando train the trainer, so he was all fired up. So we're doing vibration activation, that's raping all over the place. I'm feeling great. At the end of the call, he says, "You know what you should really do?" I'm thinking, "What? Anything this guy tells me." I said, "You should really go to Toastmasters. We're telling that to everybody here." Well, I think my response to that was simulating the sound of throwing up. I said, "What? What's the resistance?" So I just launched into this whole story. Oh my God, when I was in college, I would never take a course if you had to give a presentation. I didn't care if it was for my major, I just wouldn't take it. I couldn't do it. Then my last semester, I almost didn't graduate, so I had to take the course, and I had to present, and I got up there, and I was shaking, and I thought I was going to pass out, and not a body experience, but not in a good way. Finally, I think just to shut me up, he said, "Well, you don't have to." I'd like to tell you, I got off that phone call and said to myself, "You know, it's no big deal, he's right, I can do it, it's no big deal." But no, I got off the call and said, "Thank God, I don't have to." So as the week went on, I thought, you know, I better go to the Toastmasters site and just kind of check it out in case he brings it up again. So I get on the phone call the next week, and one of the first things out of his mouth is, "So what about Toastmasters? Did you find a group?" And I just kind of mumbled along, "Oh yeah, I went to the website, checked it out, it was pretty good, you know, watched some videos, and I didn't contact anyone." Yeah. Proceeds to start badgering me. Why have you done this? You have to learn how to public speak. It'd be so good for you. What are you going to do, sit in your house and write your blog all day? That's a nightmare. So I started to panic a little bit. I'm thinking, how am I going to get out of this? So in the spirit of a true five-year-old, I raised my voice a little bit and said, "You said I didn't have to." His response to that, respond to a five-year-old was, "Well, now you have to." So, I'm not going to lie to you, it was kind of a nightmare for me in the beginning. Just the thought of going to a meeting made me feel kind of sick inside. But Andy assured me, again, as you would assure a five-year-old, "You don't have to say anything. You just go there, you tell me coach made you come, you don't want to speak, you can just sit there." Huge place in my heart for Andy. He's helped me change my life in some profound ways. But back then, not so much. But I really need help with my business and, quite frankly, with my life. So quitting coaching wasn't really an option. So I didn't know what else to do. I went to Toastmasters. I'm here to tell you I did not die from going to Toastmasters. I did not even pass out. I found a great group of fun, funny people right in the town that I live in who are really supportive and really care about people succeeding. And they're not there to judge you, they just give you great constructive feedback. And even if you totally bomb, they'll find something good to say about your speech. And I did totally bomb. There were more ums and ahs and my speeches and all the other words combined. But you know what? I did it. And I just When I did my first speech, I was so proud of myself, even though it totally sucked. Though as time went on, speeches got a little bit better, but best of all, I got to be less and less nervous getting up in front of a group. And it almost started to seem kind of natural to get up and give a speech. I kept thinking to myself, I can't believe I'm doing this. So, and sometimes you lose your place, even when you go to Toastmasters. So, you know what giving all those speeches led to was me being able to teach my very first workshop, Infinite Possibilities, the Art of Changing Your Life. And you know what, it went great. Not because I'm the best presenter, it went great because I'm passionate about the material and I overcame my fear of getting up in front of a group. And the other great thing I took away from all of this is that I don't have to be the most polished presenter, because it's not about me. It's about the people who are showing up and really need to hear this material that we can teach them. So you don't have to be perfect. All you have to do is show up with your own unique gifts and style and show up for the people that are waiting for you. So now I'm so fortunate to be here and be able to present to all of you. And I really want to tell you that I can do this. Any one of you can do this. Andy will tell you what a complete wreck I was about just going to a meeting. Again, I'm not polished, but it's okay. So I wasn't at the time, but now I'm very grateful that Andy talked me into going to Toastmasters, because it's really helped change my life in amazing ways. So if you're out there thinking, good for you, Gwen, that's a great story. Oh, I'd love to hear that, but oh, me, not so much. No, not getting up in front of her. Sorry, my response to that has to be, well, now you have to.
Got into the conference, and
I didn't know I was scared until I got in there, and I was crazy scared. The vibration was overwhelming, and I'm pretty shy, so I like to observe versus jumping in. And the first night, I had a scavenger hunt, paper in my hand, and I froze with fear. Regina came up to me, and she gave me a big hug and said, "How are you?" And I had the scavenger hunt paper in my hand, and I said, "Not good." And she's like, and she just looked at me, and I said, "I think I might want to go home." And she looked at me like she could see right through to my soul. Has anyone had that? Regina, look at you like that? Well, if not, you might. So she excused herself and went away from me. And then all of a sudden, someone came up to me and said, "Hi, my name is Jonathan. Regina sent me over to take good care of you." And I thought, oh my God! Talk about, okay, so I was in awe, and talk about energy and vibration. I was like in awe and scared all in one. However, Jonathan stayed with me that whole night, and I completed that scavenger hunt paper. So by the end of the night, what I took away was the community is here to support you at all the time. So just reach out. Believing in someone or someone believing in you is a powerful thing. It creates superpowers, one might say. So this community, it will support you as it's supporting me to get past your fear. When I left the conference, I was really excited about all the material. And the one friend I made that made a difference in my life, and I stayed. As I waited for my flight, lots of self-doubt came into my head. Like, how are you gonna do this? You don't even know how to put a PowerPoint together. I didn't even know how to do a PowerPoint. And who are you gonna give the class to? And most importantly, who's gonna embrace your teachings? Self-doubt crept in, and from past conferences, I do realize and know that re-entry is the hardest thing and self-doubt is normal. I have a journal that I travel with. I write in it when I go on to my adventure and when I return from my adventure. So I decided I'd write in that journal, and actually it's a Mike Dooley journal. It's one of his old ones, but the new ones are cool too. And I wrote down all my negative thoughts in that journal, and then with next to that negative thoughts, I wrote down my positive thoughts in detail to cancel out the negative thoughts. And then I wrote down what I remembered to take that I took away from the conference. And that, because I was really scared that I wouldn't remember what I took away. And what I took away was a mantra from Jonathan, was just move forward. Because in the beginning, like I said, I'm really scared and fearful. So keeping that mantra in my head really made a difference for me. Resistance, I'm not new to resistance, and you might face resistance coming out and sharing this material. Resistance has been a big part of my life. I've learned how to roll this out with new thoughts so they don't even know that you're rolling it out. I started with the people I have in my life on a daily basis, my team members, my husband, and my two boys. My team, I realized one could not give a customer a better service experience if themselves don't have a day-to-day good experience within themselves. So I rolled it up with my team. I learned how to take what Mike has taught us in the 7 sections in the workbook, infuse it into my customer service in which my team provides, and to make it live there first by giving my team examples and meetings, and which then created them to shift and think differently. In every meeting, I give my team Mike Dooley's Gold Universe quotes, and they love them, and now they put them up on their workstations.
So I started infusing it into my team and into my family without them really knowing. So that's what I did for the first 9 months. But in the back of my head, I was like, how? I had no idea how I was going to actually give a workshop. None. But then I heard about this amazing Facebook page. It is Infinite Possibilities Train the Trainer. You all have to get on that page. I became friends with the community, and my world really opened up. Remember when I said I left with one friend? Well, I gained more friends than you could imagine and support from this community on this page. It's amazing. I got knowledge and friendships. They just grew. Also, remember when I said I didn't know how to put a PowerPoint together? Well, on this Facebook page, if you click under the files, there's lots of goodies under there from past Trailblazers. There's PowerPoints. You can borrow them. They're right there. You don't even have to redo them. There's worksheets. There's fun activities. This is exactly where I started. Because, again, just move forward. Anything is better than nothing. So I borrowed a PowerPoint, and I read through the presenter guide, which you guys have in your binder. And I also made sure I completed my very own workbook that I got as an attendee. That has become a huge tool for me. Then I went back to my safe people, my family, and my friends, and invited them in to give a workshop. I did it in my living room for free. I did do an invitation because I wanted to see how that would work. And then I gave another class. My second class was a public class. That was scary to come out and let everybody know what I was really doing and what my true passion was, because all they knew from what I did was that I was in the beauty industry. But really what it comes down to is beauty is within and then it's beauty without. So they only saw that I was serving them on the out instead of the in. My fourth class was a volunteer class, a nonprofit organization from Big Brothers Big Sisters. It was an amazing experience, completely different than adults. I had to really, really work on this one because their limited time for them to pay attention. So I had to get a lot of activities ready for this one. But here's the other amazing thing. There's an IP community for Teen Force Facebook page. There's another Facebook page with tons of stuff on there to get you started as well. I also got a Rubbermaid container with, and put all my stuff in there. So I had everything in there so that I would be ready for everyone that I did. I would put pens and Kleenexes and scissors and everything that I needed to do my activities right in there. What I mostly want you to take away is this. Please remember you got this. This is your passion. You will do great. IP is life-changing for the teacher as well. Mike's gifts to us is a repeatable system which you can build on. The material is set up for you to win. IP is truly magical and contagious. Go out and spread it. And as well, we are only a click away by Facebook, email, and text. This community is truly like no other. The love, the passion, the support is amazing. And if I can help you in any way this weekend, please reach out to me. Reach out to any of us. No one of us is smarter than all of us. Thank you.
Created this, but you created it too. You
and I created this. You and I are the creators. So just take that in for a second. You and I are right where we are supposed to be. We are uniquely positioned to touch the people only we can reach. There are people in the world that only you can reach. And you, and you, and you. So thank you for creating this. I remember my first conference. I was in Denver. Lee Daniel was incredibly wonderful because I too didn't know anybody, but she took me under her wing and introduced me and bought me lots of booze. So I did really well. But I was so full and so ready to go by the time I got home. I mean, I was so ready. I was like my cousin Rick on a Saturday night, full of white lightning and keys to the truck. I was dangerous. But anyway, I was ready to go. I reviewed everything. I reread the book. Oh, what a great book. I read it all the time. And I went through all of my conference material, reread and rewrote all of my notes. I looked at the Facebook page. Please get on that Facebook page. It's astounding what you will learn and the support you will get. I did everything. I looked at everything. I talked to Lee a little bit. I talked to other people a little bit. I was ready. I started making my flyer with my big IP logo right at the top. I handed it out to everybody. I got my nice blue present, you know, workaday suit. I even dyed my hair a natural color. I was ready. And you know what happened? Nobody came. It was devastated. I mean, here's my kid. My name's and so perfect, and I was making my life so much better, and here it is, and I'm ready, and I dyed my hair, and I can give it to you if you just take it. 3 or 4 days of negative affirmations later, and I tried to flip it, and I said, okay, I heard the voice of my Aunt Sue in my head saying, girl, you gotta work on yourself, and you always paid attention to Aunt Sue, because she shot her ex-husband in the foot. So I sat down with myself and I asked myself two questions. And I'm going to invite you to ask yourself these two questions, but you don't have to do it tonight. You can do it when you get home. But this is the first one. The first one is, what is it that makes time fall away from me? What is it that makes time and space no longer relevant for me? I needed to find out what my passion was, besides IP. And the second question was, how do I take that passion and incorporate it into my passion for IP and teaching? I had gotten so into it, but I had left out the most important thing. The one thing that was so irresistible that you couldn't help but come on a Wednesday night. I had left me out of it. So I sat down and answered those questions. So what is it that I'm passionate about? I'm passionate about a lot of things. There's a lot of things that I like. I love books, and I love theater, and I love people, and lots of things. But if I'm really honest, there's three things that really put me in the immediate now.
One is acting and performing. When I'm creating a character or working on a play, it's delicious. It's delicious. The second one is writing. When I'm writing a poem or an article, then and I'm playing with words and I'm slipping one against the other and I'm feeling it. Better than sex, I'm telling you. And the third is art and painting. When I get in front of a canvas and I start painting, I really am not that good, but I love it. And I put one color against the other, and I feel the edges, and I see the colors, and I get all into it, and I don't know how much time has gone by, but suddenly there's a teapot sitting on top of a bed in the middle of a cotton field, and 8 hours has gone by. Those are my three things that I'm passionate about. And for you, you have to figure out what that is for you, and it could be anything. It could be being a psychic, or being a trainer, or being a chemical engineer. It could be anything that makes you smile and come alive and forget that the rest of the world exists. And I'm not always talking about our job. Some of us are that lucky, some of us not. But I'm talking about the thing that makes you present. So if you are a chemical engineer, but organizing parties is what really makes you smile, then you need to be organizing an IP party, girl. And a big one. So how did I do it? Well, I'm a firm believer in, I'm just gonna set those there. I'm a firm believer in not recreating the wheel. And I know Mike has said that too. So I took that to heart. You've got this incredible information. You've got the workbook, you've got the presenter's guide, you've got all of this incredible information. But you also have, you've also have a whole community of badass people who are supporting you. Ow! And you have the ability to reach out to them. Sometimes they're gonna support you and they're not gonna know it, but they are. And I just wanna take a short moment to recognize some people who have always been there for me since day one, and that's Lee Daniel. Woo! And Tracy. And Mary Jo. And a couple of people who aren't here, Dee. And Rebecca's here. But that's not all. There's a whole bunch of people I don't even recognize that have done that. But you've got the means. You've got the workbook, you've got the information, you've got the friggin' lesson plans. Put yourself in there. And that's what I'm talking about. I took my acting lessons and all my improv exercises and I threw them in there where appropriate. I took my art lessons and I threw them in there where they were appropriate. So we do improv and we run down the hall shouting Dada poetry and we have a lot of fun. And we learn, and we cry, and we talk a whole lot. So what I'm asking you is to recognize your creator. You created this, and you're going to create a lot more. Because you are uniquely positioned on the precipice of creation, right now, in this moment. You are incredible, messy, unbelievably wonderful. And the most badass thing you can do right now as an IP trainer is be yourself.
I'm so excited to be here, and I'm very you guys were awesome. I really appreciate everything you say. So I was certified in San Diego just a short time ago, and maybe some of you can relate to this. I got to San Diego, and before I even went to San Diego, I kept like thinking I was going to San Diego, and then deciding I wasn't going to San Diego, and then no, it's lining up. I should go to San Diego. No, I can't go. No, this seems weird. I'm not sure I should go to San Diego. Finally, I went, and I was terrified for about, well, the first 24 hours or so. This sort of terrified me. To give you a little background on me, I've been working, the entirety of my career has been helping people. I've worked in private practice. I've worked in school settings. I have a background in psychology and social work. And so, basically, I work with people, helping them set goals, try to achieve goals, and work out their problems. Talk about their problems. For years and years and years, I have worked with people, listening to them talk about their problems. And so, that was great, and I really felt passionate about it. I really felt like that was what I was supposed to be doing. But the problem with that model was, you know, if they solved their problems, if they didn't have problems anymore, I didn't get paid. So I had this, you know, it was a conundrum for me. It was a problem for me. I didn't like it. And so prior to going to San Diego, I had been envisioning trying to do work differently, where I would work with people who wanted to solve their problems, that didn't want to just sit and, you know, kind of wallow in their misery frequently, often, sometimes for years on end. So I kept envisioning it, but I couldn't quite figure out how to do it. I couldn't quite figure out, you know, how to do it, and, you know, how do you get people to not have problems anymore and then still make money? I didn't understand how that happened. So anyway, I go to San Diego, and within, it took about 24 hours, I got the binder. I got the workbook, and it was like, you know, angels were singing, the lights went on, you know, I was amazed. It was very clear to me that all of a sudden, the universe had handed me an instruction manual, literally. It was so simple. So I was fired up. I was so excited. I came home, and I will tell you, some of you maybe came here with a plan. You kind of know what you want to do with this. Some of you maybe came here thinking you were going to form a plan when you got here. Maybe you had a plan and now all that's changed, or you know, you're figuring it out. But I went home, and my entire life changed as a result of my weekend in San Diego. My enthusiasm, my energy, my momentum, I immediately started talking to people, and I got really busy really fast, right? You have to take action. So I had my instruction manual, and I didn't stop for a minute, which is probably a good thing. I mean, it could have been a bad thing, but it worked out. It was okay. So I immediately started talking to people, and there were a couple of people that thought I had kind of flipped my lid in San Diego. They were like, "Oh, you went to California." We know most people in California. Okay, so, but I just needed to find 6 to 8 people. That's what I thought. Yeah, I'm gonna have 6 to 8 people. Gonna do a workshop, and I don't even have to do much. I have this workbook. It's super easy. It's gonna be really simple. So I managed to find 7 people, and it was, you know, I did offer my first workshop for free. This definitely is a job for me, a career for me. So I'm interested in making money. I loved in San Diego. Mike referenced, you know, the soccer moms who have money and want to do this. I'm all about helping them too. So these seven people, they were motivated and excited because I told them, you're getting a one-time offer, 6 weeks free workshop. They were my guinea pigs for sure, but they got something and I got something because I needed some valuable experience as a trainer. So we spent 6 weeks together, and what they did have to do was make a commitment to me. They had to commit to be there. They had to commit to be on time. And they had to commit to participate. So a couple of them had to think that over. There were people, you know, it's interesting how people they always think there's a catch. So like at the end of the 6 weeks, it was really funny. They're all like, wow, you didn't try to sell us anything. They didn't, you know, they were kind of amazed that, you know, it really was. I was really just trying to help them create a better life. So so I'm gonna give you some tips on things that I did to, I think, make the workshop run really smoothly and have everyone have a really good experience. So before we even began, I created an email thread and a texting thread with everybody's email addresses and everybody's text phone numbers. And I immediately started sending emails. Sounds kind of familiar, right? So I sent emails with like information, where we were gonna meet and when we were gonna meet and what we would be responsible for. And one of my good friends that did the workshop with me, she had this brilliant idea of having everyone commit to bringing food, because we did it in the evenings, once a week on Tuesday evenings, and people were hungry. And but she said, you know, people think everybody's relying on them for food, they're gonna show up. They're not gonna back out because they have food. And it was great. It was like this really, it was a really nice, it was great, it was fun. People brought food, we had a nice little social moment, and then we got busy. We did the workbook. And that's the tool that you have that can take you wherever you wanna go. It's all right there. And so between the workbook and the support that you can get from all these people in this room, through the Facebook page, through just coming up and talking to us, through our email addresses that are in the binders, you really will be unstoppable if you choose to be. So, a couple of things I want to tell you. I'm very passionate about visualizing and this whole thoughts becoming things thing. I think it's amazing. And it's really been going on for me my whole life. But when I went to San Diego, like all of a sudden I was like, oh, there's other people that this happens for. I mean, it was kind of this amazing realization for me that there was this whole group of people that could speak the same language. So during our workshop, I spent a lot of time. We spent every session we started talking about visualizations, because I made everyone commit to visualize, to spend 5 minutes a day visualizing for the entire 6 weeks that we were together, which is 42 days. And some of you might know it takes 21 days to create a habit. Also takes 21 days to break a habit. Some of you might know that better, but so 21 days. I knew if I could get people to visualize for 21 days, really create a habit, that we would actually see some changes happen, that some things would manifest during our time together. So I'm gonna tell you a couple quick stories about things that happened. So helping people to come up with visualizations and be really specific, well, present tense, very important, that they be in the present tense. So, and this, again, is all in the workbook. I'm not telling you anything you can't just open up and see. So, we spent the first session really talking about what do people want to create for their lives? What do they want to see happen? And then writing it out. And then fine-tuning it, kind of really, you know, going over, no, that's in the past tense, or no, that's not, you know, you need to make it in the present tense, really being clear about how you needed to visualize things, and how that you needed to see the end result, that you needed to feel the end result. And I had this one woman in there, good friend of mine, actually, and she said, well, here's my visualization. I need a freaking job. And I need a freaking car. My car's breaking down. And she couldn't get past that being her visualization. So we worked on it. Finally got her to say, you know, I have a job that I love. I go to every day. You know, we got it. So that it was in the present tense. And here's the cool thing that happened. So week five, and we're doing our little emailing thing in between, and she gets a call out of the blue from someone, you know, the universe, whoever. And of course, someone had a job opening, had thought of her, she was the perfect person. Was she interested? Of course she was interested. She's writing emails all in capital letters, you know, like screaming at us. She's so excited, she can't believe it. Did I know this visualization stuff works? So she goes, she gets the job, it's all great, we're all excited, we celebrate. Week six, we're there, and she says, you guys aren't gonna believe this, the job comes with a car. Okay. So exercise where I had everybody write thank you notes for something they had accomplished in the year ahead. So we're looking in the future, but you wrote a thank you note. So this is May this year, and so of course I wrote my thank you note. I'm gonna end with this. I was preparing my presentation, and I came across this, and it seemed really appropriate. So I wrote this in May of this year. I took my glasses on. Okay, here it is. Dear Mike and team, thank you so much for the amazing opportunity to speak at your event. Both presenting as well as getting to work with you with such a fantastic group of people were really dreams come true for me. The experience, connections I made, and fun that was had will not be forgotten. I'm looking forward to working together again soon and continuing to make the world a better place, one person at a time. Thank you again from the bottom of my heart, Lisa Pepper. Yeah.
Let's give them all a hand.